Hello everyone, this is Akuchi back with some more Dominion. I'm going to be playing another league match against nasmith99, one of the strongest Dominion players, perhaps the strongest at the moment. Let's see how we do. Okay, I like University quite a bit. Tormentor looks pretty good, like gainable payload. And of course, City Quarter is fantastic draw. It's a little bit awkward because there's no trashing. Usually, University is dubious if there's no way to gain draw. Caravan is like a really weak draw, as is Slay in the context of University, especially with no trashing. I wonder. On the other hand, the upside is like giving the playing a lot of tormentors. And charm makes it pretty easy to come back. When it comes to duchies, points, whatever. There is battlefield. So, like, I think the alternative to building with University is maybe doing something kind of simple with Tormentor, Den of Sins, maybe Caravans. Yeah. Don't feel really confident. About playing with University. There's no cycling. Getting deck control is a ton of work, and getting good draw off City Quarter also very challenging. I'm gonna try to not do that. We'll see how it goes. Battlefield is definitely pushing me. Definitely pushing me in that direction. Because if you're building, like, you're gonna lose battlefield points pretty hard, I think. There are some pretty nasty hexes Tormentor can give out. That's definitely the scariest thing about playing against the build big engine. On the other hand, when it comes to City Quarter draw, the duration draw does help it quite a bit. Oh, yeah, I didn't actually think about that line at all. I should have. Clearly. This is pretty nice draw. I mean, seeing Tormentor and being able to hit five is what's nice. There's nothing especially nice about having seven. So what do you do if you hit four here as a nasmith? Seems really sad. But I did give him a horse. So that is not the case. Okay. That was fortunate for N.A. Smith to see that Tormentor turn three. Just as it was fortunate for me. See if he gives me another horse. I would not. I would not say no. So I don't know if we're going to play with Charm. What is our next hand? That's pretty good, isn't it? There's a horse we don't need to play. So if we're going to get a Charm, we should get it now. Because next turn we can definitely do lots of good stuff. Yeah, let's get our charm. Falconer. Diabolical. That's really strong. I'll probably get a falconer of my own. That was pretty cool. Ooh. Is definitely nice. So the sleighs, I mean, it could be better, of course, but sleighs are interesting. Let's get ourselves a falconer. We have a silver, and N.A. Smith does not. I think we each have two imps now. Goes for city quarter. Huh. Am I going to play on or not? So I have six right now. If I buy the villa, I'll have three. We'll be drawing two cards. Like villa as a card in my deck? Not really. So city quarter, lots of slaves, that's the plan, huh? I could have gotten another imp there, but if I had played the tormentor, then bought an imp or a villa, that would have been the right, probably the best line. That seems pretty good to me. That's interesting. Okay. This is not great. So I could gain a villa. Doesn't do too much. Definitely need to get a Den of Sin. That much is clear. Could top deck it, but I'd rather top deck the other thing I get, right? That's a good city quarter. That's an okay city quarter. Another okay city quarter. That's a drawn. That's a deck that's drawn. That's pretty good. Does have 8 debt. Yeah, we are in an interesting position. Not a great position. That's really bad. That's really, really bad. Oh, that haunting is awful. I sure hope I draw an imp. Have two of them. Yeah, I really need to find my imp. Bottom decks are brutal. Brutal. Hopefully I can imp Falconer. That'd be pretty nice. We sure can. Three denizens. Could keep going. Could go charm den slay. Our opponent's gonna have a really good turn. Just seems a little too early to province. All dens remain. Slay better than nothing? I don't actually know if it is. Pretty good with imps. Yeah, I can do a free slay. Plague was really, really good hex to give. Greed and plague, pretty nasty. Miserable, yep, that hurts. Poverty is still left, and fear, those are both, well, fear doesn't hurt too much. Alright, let's see what we can do. Yeah, let's just start with that. Alright. We can gain like a caravan. That's pretty good. We have like two slays bottom decked. That's not great. Okay, so this is pretty awesome. Because we can get a province, like a charm and two dens or something. Definitely not nice to have those slays, but did we get Did we get 7 or 8 or 8 or 9 dens? This turn is definitely going to be less good because we don't have any horses. Did I give out? Oh, I gave out poverty. I'm deluded. That doesn't bother me too much. It is annoying because I can't buy a villa. Really hope to find our falconer so we can gain a villa. Otherwise, we can't play our terminals. Ooh. I guess I don't have the option to do that with the next one. Oh, there is only one horse. Duh. All right, seems fine. Want a silver? Sure. Oh no. I have regret. Actually, I think I want an estate. Yeah, I think any Smith can get those battlefield points, which I don't like. Bad omens, okay. That probably had a positive effect. If we want to play this falconer, which I think we do. Need to do it this way. We've got a bit of a problem here. We only have one den of sin here. Yikes. All right, in terms of piles, there could be some sneaky villa estate pile out. My total number of gains, however, is 5. So even if I gained 3 villas, yeah, we're not there. But it is something to keep an eye out for. This one, we could gain either a gold or probably prefer like Duchy Charm. Seems better. Yeah, this turn's gonna be pretty bad. So what do we have left? We have fear, war, envy. Envy's not gonna do too much. Something else. Oh, like, the useless one. I forget what it's called. Yeah, I mean, we can't really do much about that. We can top deck it. There's not anything else we can do. That sucks. There's some good cards down here. The good news is we don't have to worry about them, our hand size being attacked. War can't hit victory cards. Yeah, we can't lose points, and we can't have our hand size attacked. So, that's all good. I see. Gain gold to hand, that's a neat trick. I should consider that. Okay. I think we need to dance. Taking one province seems pretty risky. We can Duchy dance with the best of them. We got four Den of Sins in hand. Seems pretty good to me. I think this turn we're going to be pretty forced to province, which is fine. That was a friendly famine. Doesn't matter too much, but Alright, we should be able to province quite safely. Now this needs to be villa. Or... it could be skulk. It doesn't really get us to a useful price point, I don't think. Ooh. Yeah, let's see if we can get a little more. We didn't. Just in case it matters. All right, we have war. What is it good for? Absolutely nothing. That actually skipped a ton of good cards. Which is kind of funny. And we do it here. I mean, I could have gained a silver also, I think. No, that wouldn't have worked. All right. Pretty nasty board. We got the win there. Run helped, and then we got some good hex fortune, so I don't really know whose game plan was better. All right. You know what we're missing? We're missing plus action. Eww. What is going on here? We could play a golden deck. It's a really slow build to a golden deck. We don't have the option of opening a 5 cost. I would strongly consider Guardian Count. But we can't. Count's the only way to trash multiple cards in a turn. Yeah, I'm gonna do the same. I think I'm gonna build a golden deck. It's pretty bad, but I don't see an alternative that's any good. There's like a fool's gold golden deck, but it doesn't work if you get attacked. You really need 2 goals in this one. So it's gonna be an interesting one. I think we can probably build to windfall. Get the golds in one fell swoop. I think I'm gonna trash copper while I have the opportunity. Could be the case that we shouldn't even get anything here. Interesting. Council room money. All right. want you to match wits against my Bishop Golden deck. I'm not even. I don't even think I want to get a guardian this turn. This is a bad distribution, of course. Wonder if I should trash the scrap and do card action. Got a 1 out of 3 chance. Nope. No good. Nothing. No. It's probably fine. Should we get the Guardian while we have the opportunity? Are we gonna need a silver? We have a guardian and a bishop. Feel like we need a silver. Don't need it here, though. Okay, now we're gonna get. Let's get the Guardian. I just don't want to take any chances. Dang, this freaking draws. Brutal. Finally. you. I guess now it is my turn. Oh, I don't have the money. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. Yeah, we have it. We have windfall next turn. Somehow this worked. I don't know how, but it worked. It's pretty gross. There we go. This is more like it. I think I'm just gonna buy gold. I don't really need a golden deck anymore. Our opponent does not have a bandit anymore, so. Kind of almost even in VP. I think this gold will just give us more options and stuff. Looking pretty inevitable. Good draws there. Definitely could have had worse draws. Wonder if that's the first time I played a Bishop Golden deck in the league. All right. We've got Margrave. Plus actions are Herald or and or acting troop. Trashing is Exorcist and Ratcatcher. And upgrade. Okay. Is Druid doing? That doesn't seem very exciting. Like, getting Margrave is pretty good on the one hand. On the other hand, there's Menagerie, so probably not essential. I think I want to open with Ratcatcher. So we have Tower. I don't know how important that is. Think I will buy a silver. This doesn't gain silver, right? Not explicitly. Menagerie is pretty good. Like, we could get an acting troop. We don't have any terminal actions. Ooh, with Ratcatcher, this would have been an activated menagerie, so regrets. Ooh, lots of regrets. We don't need a druid. We have Margrave. I think we'll just buy Margrave here. I think it's a one Margrave kind of board. Yeah, it helps the opponent activate Menagerie. But it hurts their rat catcher trashing, if that's relevant. And just, yeah, I don't know. We'll see. Draw doesn't seem like a huge issue here. I think I want to play with Swamp Hag. Probably just a pair. Curses are not a huge deal. They're a little annoying. Okay. All right, so we could either ball or get a swamp hag. We've got the draw from Margrave if we see it. Nah, I think we want a ball right now. Let's get a herald and a menagerie. Oh, we had two buys. Could have just bought two menageries. Well, this is a nice draw, of course. Let's hope we have enough money in our deck. We might not. Yeah, we need to think about that. Okay, we have not trashed more than one copper, so we're fine. Okay, we have overdraw. Like, it is a gainer, but it's a pretty bad gainer. Let's just buy a swamp ag. Opponent has not trashed any copper. Getting a bunch of action cards seems like a pretty important thing to do. Ooh, so our opponent drew deck. That's crazy. I think we've misplayed this board. They have an upgrade too. Wow, two upgrades! Oh, we're screwed. We've super lost this game. I don't know what happened. It's turn eight. That's a pretty incredible. Oh no. The upgrades are played at least. Okay. But still, pretty incredible. You can use ball to get around the swamp pack. What a dumb card I picked up. And upgrade. Yeah, that's a really dumb card. Ah. All right, how do we come back into this? We need all the piles. Every last one. I guess that means, oh no. Incredible. What a turn. Interesting. What a turn. Yeah, we're pretty screwed. Like, we're gonna lose. So much overdraw. So much overdraw. Probably good to trash that copper. Upgrade would be nice. But I can't upgrade into a druid. I don't really need this exorcist anymore, though, so upgrading it seems pretty good. Maybe I shouldn't have played the rat catchers at all. Let them discard all their coppers. I mean, they didn't have to have them in their starting hand, but they did. Yeah. Margrave's a bad card, I guess. Our opponent have like six menageries. Don't think we're coming back from this. That was well played. Okay. Okay. Seer Patron. Seems like the best payload. To me. I think I'd like to open Patron Courtyard into Recruiter Rats. Well, maybe we don't get rats actually. Well, I guess it's okay. Yeah, we'll play with some. Don't really need the plus actions much. Still. Rats are, can be drawn by Seer. Coppers cannot. So, yeah. That's my plan. We do need a candlestick maker at some point for plus buy. I mean, multiple, but we'll get there. Could open border guard, but I don't mind having a courtyard. Not at all. And Smith thinking a lot. Oh my gosh, this is so bad. Do I even want to play that courtyard? I don't think so. I want to chance that recruiter next turn. That's so bad. Yay, we found recruiter. Darn. Darn, darn, darn. Church. I don't like church. As a recruiter. Does not trigger a shuffle though. I think I want a seer. I think I'll get a rats here. didn't even have to play that seer. Yeah, I think we want a lot more patrons. Border guard, huh? Okay. Meh. Dang. Come on, I have Seer and two recruiters down there. Maybe I shouldn't have played the rats first. But if I see the seer, the rats are nice in there. Ah. All right, so it's all bad. Everything's bad. The only question is, do we play this rats? We're gonna have a really, we should have a really good turn. I'm actually thinking about can't really support three rats in the deck, though. I guess they're just there. What are we doing with another patron, though? Not much. I think it's an investment towards the future. That's a really bad draw. Speaking of bad draws, opponent bottom deck their seers. Unfortunate. Oh, we found our state. Great. Do we play these rats? I think so. Only have the two seers. It's a little unfortunate, but one more. These freaking patrons! Why don't you want to be revealed? What a terrible hand. We have a lot of rats. Should make sure we trash one. It. One more. There's nothing really I want to top deck. What is that card? It's either a rats or a copper. I don't really care. All right, we need another seer. That's pretty important. Let's get a patron. Okay. We don't have patrons on our starting hand. That's good. I think we have one copper in our deck. Yeah, we do. The rat's count gives it all away. Our guard is doing work. Definitely doing work. It's a good turn. It's also a duration, church duration turn, but I think nasmith is going to be pretty reliable now. I wonder if we'll have an opportunity for a rat's autopile. Could be something to set up. Well, something to keep in mind for our next turn. He pies that, okay. No autopile. And no rats, so. Sweet. I think there's anything more to be done here. Okay. What we're gonna do like we can lower a lot because any Smith only has five bias. So we can go patron double candlestick maker or double patron candlestick maker. And like the rat's pile out is there. I don't think our opponent can do anything about that. Not missing anything, right? Is that too greedy? That seems too greedy. Probably want another seer, right? Patron seer, candlestick maker, border guard. Yeah, there's definitely a risk to not taking a seer. Those are such good draws. Ooh, I see. Courtyard into border guard. Border guard helps get coffer. But still, that was a crazy border guard. The coffer printer. So strong. Maybe I should have just gotten more border guards. Save the coffers. Yeah, so our opponent needs to province. Obviously. Why wouldn't you play that seer? What's the downside? Okay. All right. You want to church this year? Sure. No, you don't. Okay. Okay. What have you got? Okay. The race begins. Nice. Let's just grab the Oh, interesting. There's another patron down there. Yeah, it's top deck courtyard, I guess. Okay, we didn't pass up a rat's pile out. Curious. I feel like I want another border guard. Is it worth two coffers though? So we're definitely spending five. Don't know. Like, will it pay for itself? It might just end up paying for itself. Only if it reveals two patrons, though. seems unlikely. Seems unlikely. Let's just save them. This is nice. Ha. I feel like I'm in a pretty good spot. I might be able to get three provinces next turn. When I get 15 guaranteed, so I don't need too many more coffers to get it. So yeah, if our opponent takes two provinces, we win. They take one province. Well, if they take two provinces and a duchy, I think we just win. If they take one province, we need a pretty good turn to beat that. So it's probably the scariest thing. Like one province and bank up all the coffers. I would need to draw pretty well. However, nope, can't do that. The rat's autopilot is gone. Off the table, since I have provinces in my deck. The important thing is we have the most villagers. It's gonna be rough. We can courtyard into border. Whatever that's called. Border guard. I feel like we should be able to do this. If he takes one province. Take zero provinces. That's interesting. Nine coins. Put all the coffers from Candlestick Maker. So 13. Guaranteed next turn. 26. Ooh, that's a really tough spot I'm in. Yeah, if he gets six coffers from reveals. It's not trivial. It's not trivial by any means. What are we doing this turn? If we took three provinces? Where would that leave us? I think we can do it. Right, so three provinces would put us up 15 points. So our opponent would need province, triple duchy, estate. It's actually easier than four provinces. No. Hold on. Yep. Province, triple duchy, estate. That's definitely easier than quadruple province. So I think we have to hope that our opponent cannot quadruple province. We have another courtyard. So let's just plan to use that to top deck the Seer. The flaw in the plan. I think I'll just leave those three cards there. That's a copper recruiter and courtyard. That seems pretty fine. So, Thinking double dutchy candlestick maker looks pretty good. Maybe double dutchy porter guard. So far, opponent does the triple province thing. What about triple province duchy? Might not be able to beat that. Without an additional buy. Let's see. Triple province duchy. If I could go province, then triple duchy. All right, let's think about this. So if our opponent has five provinces and two duchies, we can tie that with three provinces and six duchies, and then we need an estate. So if three duchies are lowered, we need to buy, well, that doesn't work. Four provinces or four duchies. Yeah, so we need a candlestick maker, right? Think we need a candlestick maker. Alternatively, we could have done something else. No reveals there. Copper gone. No reveals there. No reveals there. We're looking pretty good. We're looking pretty good. Very nice. Very nice. So we just need to draw. Definitely possible that we don't find our seers. It is possible. We got at least six cards coming with Recruiter and Courtyard that we can look at. Still might not find them. Probably should have taken a border guard instead of that candlestick maker. Playing around three provinces duchy estate. Or three provinces duchy was what I was playing around. Yeah, I don't know. I guess he was one coffer away from three provinces duchy, so it wasn't that crazy. In fact, it was more likely than not, I think, that our opponent can buy three provinces duchy. Got some thunderstorms where I'm at. Hopefully, I don't lose power. think I'd get three provinces as any smith. Maybe estates, I don't know. That requires the most of my turn. He can't take too many duchies. Because then I can pile them. I mean, you can't take any duchies and really be safe unless you're, scoring as much as you can. So yeah. Probably, I don't know if the two estates matter at all. Let's think about it. Three provinces would put N.A. Smith up to 33 VP. I would need a province and three duchies to match that. Province and four duchies to beat it. Probably just one estate is fine. Interesting. Does any smith know when the make resign prompt is going to come up for the opponent? Or is that just crazy timing? Really? Well, I think I can just buy all the provinces that I want. If I draw, I think I need to play this rats first. It costs me a money, but I just really need to find my draw. All right. That's draw. Top deck's a province, that's fine. Top deck's a duchy, we don't want that. That doesn't help us. Well, this is a bad next turn. Don't think that matters. Can we buy four duchies? Candlestick maker patron. That costs 26? I think so. One, two, three, four. Candlestick maker patron. All right, that candlestick maker came in clutch. Maybe I would have been fine with the border guard too. Either way. All right, I'm gonna take a 3 minute break. Be back. All right, we are back. Let's figure out what kingdom we have. We have a witch and no trashing. Nope, we have bishop, but mostly no trashing. Also, plus actions are not really there either. Seems like a very painful kingdom. I heard Silk Merchant's a good card. So I guess I'll open it. Okay, so which? What is this? It's a witch. What is this? I guess we're gonna want another silk merchant eventually. Kind of like crypt. We can play with two crypts. Let's do it. Oof. Rip villager. Now we know for a certainty. This is a big rip villager. Double witch bottom deck. That's incredible. That's incredible. We are definitely cursed this game. Oh. Yeah, we can use that villager here. I think I'm into that. This is a nice crypt. So far, N.A. Smith has kept his villager. I don't believe in that. Well, I need the crypt, so probably just gold. It would have been nice to have an option to do something different. Alas. Nice. Do we want a crypt? Number two. We do. I think. I think I'll turtle this silk merchant. Get a gold, I guess. I just don't want a bad crypt, you know? That's why I like the turtle. Definitely would have been nicer in retrospect if we kept the silver on the crypt. Oof. Oof. We're gonna lose the curse split. Cannot play it if we draw it dead. I wonder if we should get a silk merchant here. Can you not bottom deck witches? Crypts also. I would really like it if you did not bottom deck. Ooh. We're getting another curse. Great. Yeah. We opened double witch on turns 3 and 4, and lost the curse split. Feels bad. I wonder what the odds are. That our opponent. See, they have one highway, they have a silk merchant, but they have no villager unless they buy one here. Ooh, okay. I don't think I need to worry. I think there's no way that our opponent can play a witch, since they played two witches that turn. They only have two. They have no villager. They have no more wishing well. There's just no way. So let's make our crypt next turn. Nice and big. In so much as we can. I've seen larger crypts. But that should last us till the end of the game, probably. We need to draw. We don't have enough to buy a province unless we draw. Oh, we do. Never mind then. Turtle is such a cool way. And I hadn't used it this way before, just as like money smoothing, but it works that way. It's really cool. Oof. Well, this is ugly looking. Wow. Incredible. Next turn should be good. Next turn is not good. Oh, we're getting screwed here. I mean, if we get a fifth province, we win, but man, this freaking 7-coin hand is brutal. Don't think a duchy helps us. I don't think a duchy helps us. So what's going on? All right, setting aside some cards. Do we get a gold or do we get a silk merchant? Could go either way. I think I'm gonna go for the gold. Oh no, if I don't draw a single coin. That crypt draw with two copper. Don't know. I don't really believe in my opponent's deck, but starting to be scared. I'm getting scared. I should have taken a silk merchant. All I need is five provinces. Like, how can our opponent beat five provinces? It seems like so difficult. I don't believe in their game plan at all. It was fortunate, unlucky for me to lose the curse split. That would have made a big difference if it went 5-5. Not sure why I bought that estate. Thank goodness. Ugh. I feel really comfortable now. So I think I'm gonna turtle by a silk merchant. Three provinces is pretty bad. Like, it's just not enough. All right, this is the big turn. I don't think you can do anything good. The fifth province was really key for me. Okay. I can't really score a point. All right, what is Duchy's worth? 24? That's not enough. Huh. Do I have to draw? Probably. I think it's super unlikely that I score, though. Or do I have a silk merchant down there? I do. This is an unusually like scary turn. So what does NA Smith need to win? Three provinces of 17. Then they need three duchies. Is that it? Three provinces and three duchies. No, that's not it. Four duchies. Three provinces, four duchies. They do have the ability to play up to six silk merchants. That is just barely enough. Okay, that's a lot of coffers too. I think we have to play for it. Okay, that didn't work. Now we know. Let's just take two estates, screw it. Yeah, now they would need five. Yeah, this is not possible for them now. Don't know how many cards they have in their crypt. Should I know that? Feel like I should know that. Three provinces and five duchies. How would that be? 32. Yeah, I can't get ahead of that. Also, they could buy a gold. No, I have three golds. Never mind. Yeah, they're out of uniques, right? Because they have four curses and three estates. Seems clear. I should buy a duchy. Because if I get two duchies, that also puts me in a really strong position. Sure, it'd be better to get a province, but whatever. All right, so what are they doing? I don't know what they're doing. All right. It's not an option available to me anyway. This is a province, so yeah, no crypts, right?
Oh no, I lost. No, I didn't lose. I have to play the witches, so they don't have enough buys. Nope, I'm totally wrong. Wow. That's the game. Just one tiny thing goes differently. Just one tiny thing. And I win. Just one tiny thing. That's the way it goes sometimes. We've had some good luck in earlier games. We had some bad luck in that game. Double bottom deck witch. That was unjust. Highly unjust. Well, what the heck is this? Feel like rat catcher is pretty important. Is it important enough to open? We could just open peasant stockpile. What is our payload here, though? I think it's soldier. So, stockpile or rat catcher? I'm not sure. Lone? That's playing with fire. I'm gonna play it safer. This freaking hand. We have our peasant bottom decks. About to flip out. Yeah, we probably want a cursed village. Interesting. I think it's gonna trigger a shuffle. It's probably okay. I think it's probably okay. It's not great though. Deluded. That sucks. We're not without advantages this game. But also, we opened Ratcatcher and have trashed fewer estates, so there's that. And we've trashed 0 copper? 1 copper compared to our opponent's 4? So, you know, that sucks. A lot. There's some really bad outcomes with loan. Really bad. Feel cheated. I think I'm gonna go with an outpost. There's definitely a risk there. A lot of risk there. Ugh. Soothsayer, it's not too bad. Trashing curses is pretty annoying in this kingdom. Look at that, the perfect draws. Probably stockpile here. But, yeah, that's pretty unlucky. Not like super unlucky, but pretty unlucky. Oh. Oh, they got a curse. Plague. Okay. They still have an estate they haven't trashed. All right. That makes me feel better. Makes me feel a lot better. Okay. Interesting. Miserable. Cool. So, Destrier. How about those Destriers? I don't know. Only gonna have one buy. probably fine. Yeah, I don't want those stockpiles. Don't think I want a teacher. Got lucky. Womp womp. Well, we can guaranteed disciple Cursed Village. Or we could disciple a peasant. Don't have a ton of money. Let's get more cursed villages. Let's stick with two disciples. Yeah, let's just go with Peasant Cursed Village, I think. It's a little too early to think about Soothsayer. Problem. Big problem. Hopefully our outpost turn is decent. A lot of peasants. Who got? I got greeted. It's too bad. I'm already behind on copper trashing. Maybe I should have picked up a loan. I think that's envy. What?
You deprive me of all my soldiers. That's annoying. Do I even want a peasant now? It's pretty annoying. I don't know what to do about that. And not exchange these once I get them. I think I have two. Maybe I only have one, though. What happened here? Yeah, okay, let's get a peasant. Well, this sucks. It's really unfortunate. We have a lot of draw cards. Okay, we have two peasants. Is that the number we want? Do we want a third peasant? No, I don't think so. Well, could like get a teacher. I think I'd rather disciple destriers though. We get a page. There could be a moment, you know. There could be a moment. This draw sucked. Six cursed villages and two destriers. Didn't draw my rat catcher either. Pretty bad. And yeah. Yeah, I haven't been trashing coppers as well. I know this. Trashed at least four, I want to say. Yeah. Whoa, it's got a teacher. We're screwed. I totally missed that. Wait, doesn't NA Smith not play with teacher? I think that's what I've heard. No teachers allowed. That dud sucked. We would have had a. I don't know if we would have had a chance. We would have made things more interesting if we had another. If we had a decent turn. This should be pretty straightforward, right? Yeah, just buy rat catchers and destriers. I think you win.
Now, there is a small chance you dud, though, on your outpost turn. So, do you take a province? Do you take a province? You don't. Oh, and you can turn a soldier or two into a fugitive. You can turn them all into fugitives. Fugitive's best card. Diabolical. Unfortunate dud. All right, well, say 3-3. Game 5 was brutal, but we got to see something kind of interesting. And that is the match. I will be playing again against N.A. Smith in a couple days for the finals of the Menagerie Mix tournament. So until then.